Oh man, that does not sound good. We're gonna have to go back to Goldenrod City here to see what's going on. So as soon as you've gotten your 7th badge, it doesn't matter which order you get them in, but as soon as you've gotten your 7th badge, you'll get that frantic phone call from Elm. And then you'll have to return to Goldenrod City. As you can see, there are rockets all over the place. Stay in the gym and stay out of the way. Alright, well, sounds like they're all four bossing people around while they're over here. Huh, man, they're blocking everything off. Friendship with Pokemon, that makes me laugh! Wow, gee. I don't know what you've heard about friendship, but I've heard it's pretty good. You can almost say it's... Anyway, we gotta go in this radio tower. That's where we need to go. Welcome to the radio tower. Maybe not, I'm sorry to tell you this, but no one can visit the tower now. Except for me, because I'm awesome! What's up? Who are you? We have business going on. No one can pass except Team Rocket. You can only come through when you're wearing a cool black uniform. Well, I want to wear a cool black uniform. Where do I get me one of those? Well, you need to have that cool black uniform. And unfortunately, you can't just knock one of these rockets out to get it. No, you actually have to go find one. And in order to do that, you're going to have to go to one of the few places that isn't blocked off. The underground! Yeah, remember that place? Way back. I think Lyra had a mural walking out of it. Anyway, down here, you need to go where that camera shop thing was, or the dress-up place. Are you a newcomer? We had to recruit newcomers from the rocket place. This guy had to borrow a uniform. And hey, what are you doing to me, man? Okay, that's a little creepy, but I mean, I can change myself. Right, so... Ooh, look at me! I look so awesome! What do you think, Marriland? Poking at garbage. Hey now. Hey now, what does that mean? I don't want you poking at garbage. No, you should be admiring my awesome, awesome... Wait. This is the enemy's outfit. What am I doing? I can't compliment this. That's not right. Oh no. Okay, so when you're wearing this outfit, you need to return to the radio tower. Because that's the only way you'll be able to do anything there. So as soon as you enter... Well, nothing happens as soon as you enter. You need to go over to this guy. Talk to him. He must be new. Go on ahead. Sure! Why not? I think I'll just do that. Oh no! Hey, Team Rocket! Stop going around in groups causing trouble, you coward. Silver, are you Devin? What are you doing here? No way. You think you're strong now? You shouldn't wear those things. Whoa! Hey, pal! Whoa! He just took off my clothes? What's that all about? What? You're not a newcomer. Then battle with me! Battle with you in the buff? I don't think so. That doesn't sound right. Oh, okay. I still do have my real clothes on, of course. That'd be a little too out there if I had to do that. So this guy, he has two Raticates on his team. Both level 24. You're strong. I know, and I'm also fully clothed, too. You're too powerful. I know. You spoil our plan. I have to inform the others. Let's see, you want to be sneaky. I'll let you handle this. I defeat Lance. After that, it's your turn. Be ready. Well, isn't that guy full of himself? Jeez, I want my outfit back. That thing looked pretty neat. Oh, man. So we're going to have to fight a whole ton of different rockets up here. Why do they want to take over the radio tower? I don't know. Why do they want to do that? We're Team Rocket. We like to cause trouble. Oh, are you scared? I'm not scared. I've just taken out like a whole ton of rockets, man. You might not have heard of Mahogany, but I had a thing to do over there. So this guy has a Rattata, level 21, a Rattata, level 21, a Rattata, level 23, another Rattata at level 23, and oh my goodness, he has another Rattata! Why do you have so many Rattatas? You might as well just call this Team Rattata. Do you think you're a hero? Well, if it means destroying the Rattatas, then in that case, I am a hero. Ha ha ha, boring. It was too easy to take over this place. Well, I don't know how easy it could be if you just come in here with like 5 Rattatas. That's almost as bad as 6 Magikarps. And you have an Arbok, level 26. And even that's like 8 levels lower than it should be. Who are you? I'm the guy that's just taking everything out, man. Yeah, so they use really weak Pokemon in here. Not just weak, but really weak. Like 3 years ago, even. Alright, whatever. On today's password. Help, of course! Help! I know, she needs some help. What's going on? Hey, pal. Hey, keep out of her way! Alright, well, maybe I will. As long as you don't come at me, bro, with a whole ton of ratatas. Oh, my goodness. Zubats, haha. You're really funny. Yeah, that's real funny there. Zubats. Haha. Arg, I give up. Well, you should. You should just give up. Trust me, if that's all you're using, you really need to give up. 3 years ago, they were gonna disband, they're making a comeback, yada yada. Ratatas! Ugh! Why were there so many ratatas in that guy's party? That's just not right. That's not a party, that's an infestation. That's what that is. I can't even call that a party. Yeah, so this guy has some sludge on his team. He's got two grimers and a muck. Ugh. Gross. Gwah, don't get cute. Don't get cute. Don't you get snippy with me, pal. I'll tell you what's cute and what's not. That attitude ain't cute. Yeah, I got poisoned, so I healed there with my magic video editing skills. Alright, the trainers, Pokemon are their beloved partners. It's terrible how Team Rocket's trying to control Pokemon. Uh-oh. What's up? I've been given strict orders. I'm to crush anyone who challenges Team Rocket. You're gonna crush me? I don't even think you could, not even if you tried. You have a coughing? Is that really going to crush me? I don't know how that's going to crush me. A grimer? That's certainly not going to crush me. Ah! No, no, the Rattata! No! Awful thing. Ah! And a Zubat. Wouldn't it just figure? Wow, you're really going to crush me with that? Mmm! Three exclamation marks. That's it. That's great. I love that. Oh, hi there. An unknown child wandering in here. Who are you? Oh, wait a second. That music's different. It's not the Team Rocket theme. Nope, it's because he's Scientist Garrett. You actually have a name there, Scientist. And he has a Magnemite. And another Magnemite. Yeah, wow. That's a lot of... Oh, wow, he has three. Dude, you should have just put them all together, taped them together with duct tape or something, and made a Magneton. I took you too lightly. Well, apparently. Whatever, pal. I don't need you. Or your magnets. So, more and more and more trainers to fight. Or rather, Rocket grunts. They're all over the place. You plan to rescue the director? So sad, that won't be possible, because I'm going to beat you. Oh, he's going to beat me, guys. What are you going to beat me with, Erratica? Erratata? Eradicate? Zubat. Yeah, you're gonna beat me with a Zubat, huh? I'd love to see you try. Just go ahead and try. Oh, a Golbat. Oh, snap. I really have to worry now. I'm shaking in my boots. And a Grimer? Yeah. That's just icing on the cake. It's like the frosting. No, unbelievable. Yeah, unbelievable. There's so many trainers in here, and they're all so weak. Yeah, so as you can see, you have to fight, like, a whole ton of Rocket Grunts and Scientists and stuff. But they're all really weak. Why do I have to suffer? Meowth, help me! Team Rocket, there's something they lack. Music! You'd never do such horrible things at places like the Radio Tower. Proton, the leader of this Radio Tower mission, he is so cool! Who are you? If you're in the way of Proton, I mean Team Rocket, I will not allow that. Wow, sounds like someone's got a crush! Oh yeah, she so has the hots for Proton over there. Wouldn't they make just the greatest couple? I mean, she looks exactly like all the other female Rocket Grunts. She has an Ekans level 21, an Ekans level 21, I'm not repeating myself, an Ardish level 23, and a Gloom level 24. Yeah, that's just lovely. Oh no, they're so useless. Yeah, they're so useless, all right. They're all I need. Who cares about Pokemon? That was a question. Who cares about Pokemon? It wasn't an exclamation. It was a question. I care about Pokemon. Most excellent. This Radio Tower will fulfill our grand design. Oh, aren't you just a little creepy there, Scientist Trenton? He has a Porygon on his team. Level 30. Now, there's something that's almost a challenge. Almost a challenge. Don't get too smug, though, because you are going to have to fight some stronger trainers coming up. The boss of this place, he's really tough. He's not the one you'll see in this video, though, but he is pretty tough. Just giving you the heads up. Oh, snap. Up here. It's the director. That's the guy I need to save. Except, you know what? My spider senses are tingling. I forgot to fight a trainer down on one of these floors. I think it was actually two floors ago. I couldn't remember where he was because, you know... yeah, so actually, it's this guy that I need to fight. Feels great ordering Pokemon to commit crimes. Wow, what kind of a sick, twisted sense of humor do you have there, pal? Really? Oh, he has a wheezing. Well, that explains it. Ugh, that's not good for Marriland. Whatever. You're kidding! No, I'm not. I'm serious. Ugh. The Team Rocket boss has locked himself in. The director's up on the fifth floor. Please save him. Oh, I need a card key. Oh, that's just great. Yeah, so switch out for Daisy May here. And I need to go talk to that director guy. Because clearly he's the person I want to talk to. Maybe he can save the day, or maybe I can save him, right? Right? Ah, couldn't be so true. Do you hear me? I'm the director. We want to broadcast wonderful praises to Team Rocket. Uh-oh. I'm busy impersonating the... Who are you? It's you again, Devin. No. I was pretending to be the director to influence Team Rocket. This time I won't hold back. Oh, he's giving me everything he's got now. It's Executive Patrell. Oh, snap. And he's got 6 Pokemon on his team. Want to guess what they are? No. Don't tell me they're all coughing. Oh, no. That'd be awful. Well, it may be a lot better than Magikarps or Rattatas, but you are going to have to fight a lot of coughing. And this can be rather annoying because I believe each and every one of these coughing have the capacity to blow up at any moment and do massive damage, or at least a pretty good amount of damage. So you really have to be careful when you're taking them on. Psychic types are obviously the way to go, but oh, he has a wheezing on his team too. Snap, it's not just coughings. This is not good. I'm gonna send out mind games for some serious business against that wheezing. Yeah. All right, sludge face. Let's hope I can go first. I really don't want you to blow up. That'd be bad. Hopefully confusion will do enough to take it out. Come on. Ah, not enough. Sludge. Darn that sludge. All right. No! You little jerk! How dare you blow up on me? Ah! Curses. No! Man, what did I tell you? That's just a real jerk move. What a little punk nugget. All right, Daisy May, you're gonna have to clean up the mess here. Now they're coughing. Yeah, so after that wheezing's out of the way, he only has the 5 coughings, of which I've taken 1 out already. And I believe they can all blow up, too. So try to take them out as quickly and swiftly as possible. Waste no time. And remember, it's floating. It has levitate, so ground-type attacks don't work on it. That kind of leaves me without too many options, because grass-type attacks aren't going to be very effective against these things either. So I'm just going to have my cow use Zen Headbutt a whole ton of times. Yeah, because that's somehow magically effective against coughings. Don't blow up, please. Alright, well that's good. Maybe it's just the wheezing that can blow up. I don't know. Maybe I'm not thinking straight here. Oh yeah, drink some milk. I'm not even going to try to explain the logics behind that. But whatever. If it makes for a good snack. And if it heals your hit points, all the power to you, Daisy May. Let's finish it off with Body Slam, because it's more accurate than Zen Headbutt. And, also because I might as well conserve its power points. Coughing? Oh no! Another coughing! How can this be? It's just such a big surprise. So I think I'll take this thing out in a similar manner with Zen Headbutt! And it's probably not going to do enough to knock it out. Yeah, didn't think so. So I'm just gonna have to endure another sludge. Hope I don't get poisoned. And take this thing out. I guess I could have used Body Slam there, but whatever. I don't really care. Now these coughings do have a lot higher defense than they do special defense. So if you have like a strong water or electric type or fire type or something, and it has special base attacks. What? Am I losing? Yeah, you're losing. And you're a loser, too. But if you have, like, one of those types and it's special based, you'll find that you'll probably be able to take these coughings out pretty easily. Oh, now you poison me. Oh, man. You poisoned my cow! How dare you! Go on, Daisy May, hit that thing with some Zen Headbutt! Ah! Why does it take so much to take out these floating purple spheres? Why? No! No! My cow! You fainted my cow! Now I'm going to have to do this the really hard way. Hey, wait, are you serious? Yeah, I'm serious. I'm whipping out the big guns now. I'm sending out a grass type against your stupid coughings. Awful things. Thankfully, that was the last one. Okay, I'll tell you where he is. Ugh, stupid. Stupid. Listen carefully. We stashed the real director in the underground warehouse. It's the far end of the underground tunnel. So he gives you the basement key with gratitude and tells you you gotta go down there to save the real director. So, since we need to get that card key... Oh yeah, Marriland's very eager. He's so eager. Since we need to get that card key, it's time to return to the underground basement in the next episode of Marriland's Pokemon Soul Silver Adventure.